they'll line up against Halstead. Minneapolis boys lost to Bennington yesterday. No, it was Tuesday. And yesterday, the Halstead boys lost to Sacred Heart. So they lost in overtime, if I'm not mistaken. Well, I guess they lost Tuesday night also. I'm just
kidding. Yes.
Both teams played Tuesday. We played in the afternoon, and Sacred Heart Halstead played in the evening. I'd say Halstead lost in overtime to Sacred Heart, and the Lions were beaten by Bennington by around 15 points, if I'm not mistaken. So we play for the right to go on to the fifth place game if we win tonight. We have a common history of playing Halstead twice now in the previous tournaments here in Salina. We're a 1-1 split with them. So not a real long history, and it's all been here in Salina. The one victory we have was in 2004 by 15 points in the tournament championship.
Well, if we lose, we end up playing Friday at 2:30 in the afternoon. That's pretty early.
I'm hoping we win. Win number one. Well, the Lions are 0-2 on the season.
Halstead not supporting a really, really tall team. They have 2 6'1" boys and 2 5'11", and quite a few of them at 5'10". There's a Regeer there and a couple other names that you'll recognize during the telecast, Ratzlaff and Regeer come to mind anyway.
So we are going to be battling for height, being down by in height today like some teams. But the Lions have been outscored in the first two games by an average of 52-40. And as I said, Halstead lost in overtime to Sacred Heart by a score of 70-61. They were led by Tyler Armendariz with 18 points. That will be a number 21. He's a senior, probably a point guard, I'm guessing. So those of you watching on the tape delay here on Channel 37 MCTV, it'll be number 21. The game again brought to you by the MHS Linebackers on Channel 37 MCTV, tape delayed, and brought to you live on www.910kina.com. Audio stream on a live basis. Dale Leach, Mike Perry, and Charles Lomberger here to bring you the contest. The Lions have had a little bit rough go here to start off the season. We haven't scored as much as I think I'd like to see them score from the outside. They've been kind of hampered inside by a height advantage to some of the teams, a couple of the teams we've played.
Halstead will start 2 6'1" boys and a 5'11". The other two guards are 5'7" and 5'10", so not extremely high or tall, but looks like they're an athletic bunch, about like we are, so I think we should match up rather well tonight.
I certainly hope so.
And by the looks of them warming up, shooting the three balls, we probably are going to have to play the three-point line fairly close. I know Coach Shoup's got the boys playing pretty tight man-to-man. And I think probably we'll look to see him shake that up, maybe go with a zone here and there just to switch up defenses. We're ready for the introduction of players here in about 20 seconds. Minneapolis to start Kyle and Corey Lomberger, Keegan McCulloch, Logan Weedle, and George Schmidt. A lot of our bench plays quite a bit, as K Casey Argenbright off the bench pretty quick, along with Grayson George.
And Charlie Lynn.
And Charlie Lynn's been
some time in there underneath the basket,
logging a lot of minutes. It's warm inside and a little chilly outside. Today when we came in, we brought our jackets with us.
The
still got them on.
Warm fuzzy temperatures on Tuesday are long gone.
McGeer's brother played, I thought it was Hillsboro, but it must have been Halstead. Very good ball player.
Kyle averages 2 points a game so far this year. Corey's brother's averaging 10.
Vermillion. Ratslav.
Jared Schmidt's averaging 6 points.
Armendariz.
Big gun. Logan Wheel averaging 9 points so far this year.
Armendariz 5'11", but does the bulk of the scoring for the Halstead Eagles. Are the Eagles? War Eagles?
Dragons.
Dragons. Keegan McCulloch rounds out the lineup for Minneapolis along with Derek Gant for Halstead, 6'1" junior.
Keegan McCulloch averages 6 points. It's nice to see Keegan not quite so much foul trouble the last game as he was in the first game against Russell.
Foul trouble has been an issue in one of the ball games, not so much the other night against Bennington, but
against Russell it certainly was. He
can't go too deep with a lot of foul trouble.
Spent a lot of time riding pine.
Kyle will jump center.
Our tall post player here.
I think he just has more ups than anyone else on the floor. That's why they put him there. But he will jump against Ratslav. And we're underway. Armendariz moving a little bit on Keegan. They do just barely get the tip. Kyle right there. And we're underway. Halstead, Minneapolis. Man-to-man defense by the Lions. Entry pass rolls it right back out to Legere. Now on the wing, they're looking to reset the offense here as Corey Lomberger plays good defense, and Kyle with the overplay. They have it in the corner, skip pass to Legere, back three-point shot is no good. And Corey Lomberger pulls down the rebound on a nice block out by Jared Schmidt. And we've got a reach-in foul on Ratslav. We play it in. Keegan with the ball over to Kyle. Kyle on the wing, and it's definitely a zone defense being applied to the Lions by the Dragons here. 7:07 left, no score.
Into Keegan down low. Backs up Corey.
Corey with a nice shoulder and head fake gets the Dragons defender up in the air, drives to the paint, and it's a nice little 12-foot jump shot. Now they got it in close, and they miss. Tipped out there. And the reach in as Kyle is getting his arms out of the way. Catches the cheekbone of Legere and incidental. Hammer.
Is that official timeout?
Yeah.
Okay.
And men in stripes call a timeout to let Regeer gain his composure there a little bit. Tight man-to-man here by Minneapolis. Back door, Veslav up and in. Quickly down the floor, Schmidt passes it back to Corey. It goes off the shin. Now Kyle back to Logan. Three-point shot is rimming off. Hit three in a row last Tuesday. Logan back to defend as Halstead quickly gets Armendariz the ball. Three-quarter court pass, and Logan stops the easy layup, but Ratzlaff will go to free throw line, or Armendariz will, for a two-shot free throw. First one up and in for the Dragons, and they take an early 3-2 lead. Off the back rim, Ratzlaff gets the rebound, and Keegan McCulloch out horses Armendariz for the ball. Corey, nice pass to brother Kyle. I think he lost the handle on that a little bit. The ball slipped out of his hand as he was going to the basket in on the baseline. Armendariz top the circle. Ratzlaff. Three-point shot is no good, and Ratzlaff right there underneath for the garbage. Sticks it right back up and in. Jump stop by Corey in the paint. Keegan comes in. The rebound now, Logan Riedel. Baseline shot is good. Nice hustle by Keegan McCulloch to claim that rebound. Now Ratzlaff on the move. Halstead. Shot by Armendariz. No good. And Kyle Lomberger comes out there with it. Jump stop again. Corey in the lane. It's good. They're going to count that and call a foul on Halstead.
Second team foul.
And don't get me wrong, but Halstead's going to change out 5 for 5.
Well, yeah, it's nice when you have the depth you can do that.
Yeah, with the first personal foul there for Halstead, and Corey will go to the line to try to extend this Minneapolis lead as Grayson George heads to the scorer's desk for his first duty of the afternoon. Corey's free throw is up and in. It
wasn't too long ago we witnessed Burlington win a Class 3A championship doing that.
Yes.
7-5, Minneapolis. 5-3 to go in the first quarter.
Garnett now in for Halstead. I'll try and pick up the other players as we go along. Full court pressure by Minneapolis is working. Ooh, Grayson just barely missed that, and the pass goes out of bounds off the hands of Boulette. And Keegan will chase down the ball over on the concrete, and we're ready to play again. As Coach Shoup grabs Argenbright for his first duty, Corey out on top. It's a 1-2-2. They drop down into that. There's a nice entry pass to Grayson George, and his first shot of the day is up and in.
9-5, Minneapolis.
6-1 freshman from Minneapolis cans this first bucket. Schmidt with a good defense, and George picks up the loose ball. We have numbers. Corey smartly pulls up, shoots that 12-footer, just back rims it. And Halstead on the move now. Has it in close, and Burnett draws the foul on Keegan McCulloch.
His first, Minneapolis second.
Garnett will shoot two for the Dragons as Charlie Lynn heads to the scorer's desk. And Coach Shoup starting the rotation. Barnett's first throw is up and missing as Argenbright and Lynn come in. That's been the tendency so far, Shoup playing eight. And that just barely draws iron by Garnett. And they corral the long carom. Skip past the other side. Minneapolis has moved into a little bit of a zone here. Changing up the defenses. Turnover by Halstead and Minneapolis gets the ball right back. Vermillion back in for the Dragons along with Armendariz. Quick breather and they're back in. Nice entry pass. Retzlav has Corey on the arm and we'll play it in under our own bucket. That's good. That's the second personal foul. They're counting it off. Somebody needs to move. And Charlie Lynn comes to meet the ball. Corey with a nice baseline shot. It's no good. And Grayson George, nice stick back, just rims off. The backside, Schmidt, ooh, lost his footing. And they go to the rack for an easy bucket. That's loud. Beats us back on defense. Schmidt with a steal attempt.
9-7, Minneapolis. 3 minutes to go in the quarter.
Schmidt with the ball between the rings now. Casey Argenbright looking inside. Got a moving screen on Schmidt.
Third team foul, first personal. Each team with three fouls now.
Number 23, Logan Wheeler.
I was going to say, stay back, Charlie. They've got numbers on you. Kyle back in, along with Logan Weedle. Armendariz behind the defense.
Oh, my.
Kyle anticipating a little different move. No, it's just,
I think it was quite an intentional
foul on Kyle, and Armendariz will go to the line to shoot two.
Unfortunate.
He got Kyle up in the air, and Kyle had nowhere to go but on his back. It was a good move by Armendariz. Kyle going for the block. First free throw is no good. They don't shoot free throws well at all, do they?
Kyle didn't hack on him or anything.
No, I... That yeah, made it legal.
They are one of... five so far.
Two of six from the line for Halstead. Not found the range yet from the free throw line. Logan Weedle out on top with the ball. Corey double teamed out front and he gets caught in the air with his pass and Halstead intercepts. Three-point shot, doesn't even draw iron. They hustle back, get the ball on a layup. Second chance. Foul on Charlie Lynn there on the defensive boards. Armendariz. They'll call that on the floor. I thought they were shooting, actually. Halstead will play it in under their own basket here. Gant back in for the Dragons. Back out front, Armendariz. Guarded closely by Kyle. Long shot. Oh, he's going to go in sooner or later. He has shot it.
That was the fourth attempt.
Vermillion has taken three or four attempts. It looks like he likes to shoot the three ball. There's a nice move by Kyle. They call that on the floor. That will be Vermilion's first foul.
It's 11-9 now, favor Halstead.
Buck 43 left first quarter here. Logan Weedle to play it in for Minneapolis. McCulloch out front to Logan. They fight through the screen now. Grayson on the wing, looks inside. Now out front to Corey. Logan had a quick look at a three, but couldn't pull the trigger. And Coach Shoup wants a full timeout here. Trailing by two, Halstead 11, Minneapolis 9.
We'll be back.
Corey to trigger it for Big Blue. Well, I better not say Big Blue, Halstead in blue, and Minneapolis
or Big White.
In whites. Kyle, now a nice pick by Keegan McCulloch. Frees up Corey for a minute. Back to Logan. It's a man-to-man defense now by the Dragons. George off to the wing to McCulloch. Now Corey resets the offense for the Lions. With a minute left, first quarter. Between the legs, dribble down the paint. Gets it off to Kyle, now back to Logan. Grayson George, three-point shot just short. And we got a walk as the ball was on the shoulder of both linebackers. They couldn't get a handle on it. Grayson with a good look at a three, just comes up a little short.
Those will fall for Grayson eventually.
Full court pressure by Minneapolis. Halstead has numbers. George gets back quickly. Now shot on the wing is no good. And they got Armendariz on a walk. As Minneapolis working the boards, Armendariz loses the footing, and we've got a sub here real quick. No. Yes. Now he's going to let him in.
Yes, no, no, yes.
Ratcliffe and Ratslav. We got numbers deep. We break the pressure in good fashion. Corey now with the back, behind the back dribble, gets the ball off to Kyle as he rescues the ball. Skip pass to Logan Riedel. Kyle got an opening. And Armendariz out-muscles Keegan for the ball. And Armendariz gets his own follow-up. Slips in there past the defense for an easy bucket.
13-9, 2 seconds to go. And on Halstead at the end of the quarter.
Right at the end of the quarter, they pick up a cheapie. Murray
five.
Has Corey on the arm. And that's the fifth team foul on Halstead. Each team now with five team fouls. And that's the way the first quarter will end. Halstead 13, Minneapolis 9.
You gonna join the squad over Christmas break or something?
We can only hope.
Yes. Getting ready for the second quarter to begin?
I still think we need to put a microphone in front of Charles Lomberger. He's part comedian and part camera operator. He's a joy to work with up here. Plus, he's a track junkie just like me. We inbound the ball here to start the second quarter. McCulloch now on the wing to Schmidt. Schmidt looking inside, back to Logan. No space to pull the trigger on that three ball. And we reset the offense, man-to-man here. Now in the corner, Grayson has an open look, and it's short. They're on the move. They have numbers. Skip pass on the wing, and three-point shot is rimming off, and Logan Weedle controls the boards for the Lions. 13-9. Corey over to Logan. Inside to Corey. He posts up rather well for a guard. And they got him on the arm. 16 foul on Halstead.
Not in the act of shooting. They've had more shooting free throws than we've had so far.
One more foul, Minneapolis will be in the 1-1 as Ratzlaff comes back in. And Corey will throw it in for Minneapolis. 7:15 left. Second quarter. Schmidt loses a handle on it. It goes way over the corner to Wheel. He saves it. Now Halstead has numbers. Easy layup. Regeer with an easy layup for the Dragons.
15-9 Halstead.
Nice move by Corey. A jump stop. Bank shot off the glass and in. Nice steal by Logan Wheatle. He'll have an easy layup. And it goes in. Nice anticipation by Logan Wheatle on the wing. With a steal. Now Minneapolis back to within two. Long pass. They have numbers again. Armendariz inside. It's good. We got to hustle back on defense. Garnett.
17-13. Halstead.
And Halstead's back in that zone defense. Logan Wheatle, three-point shot, rims off, and Garnett with the ball on the other side. That should be white ball. Yeah, good call. As Schmidt wrestles Garnett for that rebound. It goes off Garnett and out of bounds. Minneapolis to throw it in. 17-13, Minneapolis needs a bucket right here. Keep this one position. And we weren't where we thought we were going to be as Corey threw the ball and no one there. Now the three-point shot. Corey working on some position down low is whistled for the foul. Minneapolis 16 foul.
His first.
Argenbright back in for Minneapolis. And the Dragons will play it in. Easy pick on the backside. And Minneapolis Bulls play that game quite often on the inbound.
19-13, Halstead.
Schmidt with the ball. We're overloading it. And we're getting our gaps just like we should on a attack this zone. We had somebody inside now, Logan. Back to Argenbright. Jump stop. Back to Kyle. Hey, that's a thrill one up, yeah. Vermillion with the ball out on top. Garnett with the ball. Jump shot there, and it goes out of bounds off two Halstead players. Murray and Gant both had a hand on it. It went out of bounds. 5:06 left first half, 19-13. Halstead with a lead here. Schmidt now to Argenbright. Now the entry pass to McCulloch. He's open. Passes up the shot there in the paint. Logan back to McCulloch again. Right hand one-hander in the paint is good. Keegan McCulloch with a nice one-hander there in the lane. Right hand that time.
19-15, Halstead.
Ambidextrous young man can shoot any shot either hand. Nice move by Armendariz. Gets his own rebound and stick back is good. He can get to the basket. That's why he scores 17 points a ball game.
Halstead.
Keegan with the ball on the baseline back out to Schmidt. And they get him on a walk. Traveling call by Schmidt. 21-15, Halstead.
Six turnovers, both teams, first half here.
Vermillion bringing it up as Argenbright flies the defense. Regeer on the wing being guarded by Logan Weedle. Man-to-man defense by the Lions. Regeer cuts through the lane. Now Armendariz has the ball at the free throw line, rattles one in and out. Gant with the offensive board is fouled on the stick back. He will go to the line to shoot two here.
Jared's second. Team seven.
First player with two fouls, Jared Schmidt. Gant. First throw is in and out.
I'll tell you what.
They don't shoot the free throws well, do they?
They've been quite the poor for their sakes tonight.
Three out of seven.
Two out of seven so far.
Corey comes back in and Schmidt heads to the bench with 3:31 left first half. Two fouls here in the early going on Jared Schmidt. Second throw is no good, and Casey Argenbright does what you need to do on that free throw is to take the shooter and has the easy rebound. They're going to call that on the floor, but that will put Keegan at the free throw line for a 1-1. As Ratcliffe has his second personal foul. Gant comes out and Garnett back in. Pretty interchangeable, aren't they? But 6 foot for 6'1" and 6'1" for 6 foot. Keegan's first throw. It did draw iron. Front rimmed it, went straight to the floor. Now Corey with the good defense. Argenbright comes up for the double team. Back out front, Vermillion sets the play for the Dragons. Regeer, baseline drive, no good. And they're going to call over the back on Garnett. As Keegan had really good position. Keegan will be back at the line for the 1-1 here. First throw is no good. Armendariz on the move now over to Regeer. Pulls the trigger pretty quick over there, doesn't he?
Yep. Ball hits top of the rim. Turns over to Minneapolis.
Yeah, ball hit the shot clock.
Top
it's
rim,
out of play.
Clock, yeah.
Almost would have went back in. Kyle with the ball quickly into Keegan. Back to Kyle. Corey clear out on top. 2:38 left. First half.
Lions down by six. 21-15.
Halstead back in the man-to-man. They switch up defenses. Now Corey's got Ratcliffe posted up, but they call a foul on Corey Longberger. Whistled for the hold when he was trying to get position in the paint. His second foul. Now Schmidt and Longberger with two fouls apiece as Argenbright on Vermillion. Ratcliffe, three-point shot, no good. Armendariz over the back, it's not called. Three on three, and Argenbright pulls it back out. Kyle. Skip pass is intercepted, tipped out there by Halstead. And we'll play it in with a minute 56 left first half. Twenty-five 21-15, first half. Logan Weedle looking on the wing. Corey comes to get it to reset the offense. Man-to-man defense here by the Dragons. Corey, nice crossover dribble. He gets all the way to the rack. A nice runner in the lane, Corey Lomberger.
8 points for Corey so far tonight.
Nice steal by Casey Argenbright. We have numbers. Corey, baseline shot, no good. And somebody undercut Keegan. Ninth team foul on Halstead, and McCulloch will go to the free throw line for another 1-1. 21-17, we could use a couple right here. No good. Kyle, doing a good job on that offensive glass. Armin does. Now on the move, the Dragons out front. Minute 15 left. Vermillion. Armendariz gets the ball on the wing, now out front to Garnett.
21-17, Halstead.
Looking for that back door, aren't they?
1 minute to go.
Play out front, Armendariz now. Regeer. Looking for the ball, they cannot get it to him. Good tight man-to-man defense here by the Lions. Murray with the ball clear out on top. Guarded by Logan Weedle. Now Garnett's pass to Regeer, almost intercepted by Corey Lomberger. Switch off has Logan Weedle on Murray now, clear out on top. They do want the last shot here, don't they? 21-17, Halstead. 10 to shoot. Armendariz now in the wing. Vermillion gets the three-pointer off. No good. And they get the rebound. Stick back is no good. As Garnett had it point blank and misses. And we clear the board. And that's the way the first half will end. Minneapolis 21, Halstead 17. Oh, no. Halstead 21, Minneapolis 17. 4-point lead here for the Dragons as we go into halftime.
We'll be back after some advertisements here. Some words from our sponsors. Okay, back here for some unofficial stats. Wrap up time here. The Lions are shooting 47% on field goals for the two-pointers. They're 8-17. They're 0-4 on trays, 1-4 on free throws for 25%. We had 4 steals, 11 rebounds. We had 8 fouls, they had 9, so we're pretty close on fouls. Turnovers, the teams had 6 each. They had 8 of 21 on field goals for 38%. They're 1 of 9 on trays. Boy, if they were hitting those trays, sending those trays, we'd be in a world of hurt. And they were 2 of 8 on free throws for 25%, like us on percentage. Big difference in the game so far, Mike. Halstead, 19 rebounds, Minneapolis 11. They've got some good putbacks underneath the board.
Yes, they have.
Advantage.
Kept them with the advantage. As Dale mentioned, not shooting ball well from the outside or the free throw line. 1 of 9 from beyond the arc. And probably 2 of 8, 2 of 9 from the free throw line or so.
They're 2 of 8 on the free throw. We're 1 of 4, so both of us 25%. They've had more opportunities at the free throw line. They haven't been able to connect. They had some shooting fouls. A lot more opportunities because of shooting fouls than we've had. So.
Halstead doing a pretty good job mixing up the defenses between the zone and man-to-man. Minneapolis doing a pretty good job attacking. They're getting some open looks. We just need to knock down a couple more of those threes and get our free throws. I think we'll be in pretty good shape.
We're down 21-17. Four-point deficit also at the end of the first quarter. Each team scored 8 points.
We missed 3 of the front end of the 1-1s there that really hurt.
Yep. Yeah. Hopefully some improvements can be made there. But that's the story of the first half. We'll be back for the second and see if the Minneapolis Lions can pull out their first victory
of the year. All right, welcome back for second half action. Here again, the Lions trailing 21-17. Halstead will inbound the ball with the possession arrow. Weedle, McCulloch, Lomberger, Lomberger, Schmidt start for the second half.
Breslaff gets it in to Vermillion. Slick little guard there, likes to shoot the three, hasn't had too much success. Now the backdoor attempt and a good defense by Minneapolis.
Keegan, I think, draws the foul.
Yes. Keegan with the reach-in foul. That's his second. Vermillion free throw up and in. I think he can shoot free throws. 22-17, second throw is good. Corey now on the move. It's a man-to-man. Breslaff on Schmidt. Kyle. Logan looks inside. Schmidt's there on the baseline. Not a good pass. So he tries to thread the needle. Tipped out there by Breslaff, and Minneapolis will play it in. Right in front of our bench. Schmidt now out front to Keegan. Logan looks for an opening. And Armendariz is right with him. Kyle with his back to the basket. Turnaround jump shot, no good. Shot misses. Now they have numbers. Kyle back quickly on defense. And Logan has called for the foul as Ratzlaff with the left hand goes all the way to the rack. That's Logan's second foul. Not typically in foul trouble at all. Etzlaff's free throw rims off. And he'll get the second one here as Halstead out to a 6-point lead. Left hand throw is good. Right through the hands. Quick pass as Minneapolis moving the ball up court quickly. And it's turnover Minneapolis as Halstead will play it in. Vetslav finally gets it into Vermillion. Regeer on the move, 3-on-3, and they pull it back out. Regeer with the ball. Armendariz has the baseline. Jump shot, good. He's tough inside, 5'11". He gets you on his hip, and he's money at the basket. Nice little bank shot. Corey, jump stop. Bank shot, good. Corey Lomberger. Oh, my. They're all alone. Layup, good. We all get back on defense, and Halstead makes us pay. Corey in the lane out to Schmidt. Baseline drive, jump shot, good. Minneapolis on the move now. Corey, the good defense. Vermillion with the crossover dribble. Armendariz down the corner, back out to Regeer. Three-pointer is good. Everyone's starting to warm up a little bit, Dale. Shooting a little better from the outside now. 31-21 lead. Halstead hits the three ball as Regeer, a good spot-up shooter, along with the guy who has the ball now, Logan Weedle. Jump shot by Corey Lomberger rims out. Regeer, not much of a slasher as his brother, but does have the three-point shot in the arsenal.
Oh, my.
Armendariz runs over the top of Kyle. Vermillion. Three ball, that's good.
2-on-3 is this half for him. 34-21.
Kyle with the ball in the wing. Skip pass to Keegan. Jump shot, good. The left hand push shot. McCulloch with a nice floater there on the elbow. Nice shot by Keegan. Now Regeer all the way to the basket. It's good. Just said he wasn't a slasher, and he takes it all the way to the rack. Corey, between the leg dribble, jump shot by the Payne and Armendaris. Excuse me, that's Garnett, comes out of there with the ball. Now Regeer has the ball stolen. It goes out of bounds. It will be Halstead's ball as Corey tries to save it.
Two freshmen come in, Grayson George and Casey Hardaway. Weedle and Kyle on the right down. We don't call that on
Keegan. They did. He was straight up. I don't know. Not much of a foul in my eyes, but Garnett to the line to shoot two. Free throw, no good. Free throw shooting woos continue for the Dragons, with the exception of Vermillion, who looks like he can shoot free throws. Garnett's second throw is rims in. Charlie Lynn back in from Minneapolis. Schmidt with the ball quickly up the floor as Halstead gets back. Now Argenbright resets the offense for Minneapolis, and between the rings there's Corey Lomberger, now to Schmidt. Grayson looking for the ball on the wing, and we throw behind him as he cuts to the basket. It's out of bounds. Turnover. Minneapolis, Coach Shoup calls a timeout. Full timeout. We'll be back after this timeout. Halstead 37, Minneapolis 23. As Minneapolis not getting back on defense. And the buzzer goes off, and we're ready for play.
Nice steal by
Corey. Grayson George. Back out front to Argenbright. Corey whistled for the offensive foul there. Now he'll have to watch it playing with three. Retzlaff back to Vermillion. Corey's got the tough draw. Vermillion, a slick little guard. Backdoor Corey, he's right there. They kick it out to 3-point shot. Corey's got pretty decent position. And Schmidt comes back in to commit the foul, I believe. Yes. Schmidt's third. 15 foul on Minneapolis already here in the early going. Second half, Halstead, none. That's five. That one crawls in over the rim. It's good. He'll get the second one. Second three for no good. And they're going to whistle Garnett. Now,
what?
That foul actually was on number 42, Charlie Lamb. They better get that corrected right now, because they gave that to Corey. And then they give Schmidt a foul.
I'm just confused. Bodies everywhere. Arms slicing down other arms. No fouls. All of a sudden, somebody finally gets the ball, and they have another reach in and get a foul. I don't understand the sequence there.
Well, he called that foul on Charlie Lund. The announcer named Corey Lomberger the foul, and that was, I'm afraid, we've got a problem here.
Now the refs and...
Thank you. That was close. I thought that was going to stick, and
Jared Schmidt has four fouls.
Yeah.
This puts us at
Schmidt has four and Corey has three.
Seven fouls, so they have a 1-1. Then he makes the first.
39-23. Ratcliffe makes the second one. Retzlaff. Corey, nice crossover dribble, loses the handle. Garnett picks it up. Vermillion on the wing to Regeer. No good.
Now over the back there.
And Retzlaff. Corey in the lane, dumps it down to Charlie Lynn, not looking for the pass. That's definitely Corey's shot right there. He should just go ahead and take it. Grayson back in from Minneapolis. Man-to-man defense here by Minneapolis. Behind the back dribble. Now, Retzlaff into Armendariz. He loses the handle. Kyle picks up the loose ball from Minneapolis. Sorry, you're not going to beat Kyle down the floor. Argenbright now in the wing to George. Logan has an opening for a minute. Casey Argenbright. Kyle with the ball on the wing now, Casey Argenbright. Nice pass to Logan Weedle. Good look by Casey Argenbright, the assist, and Logan with the points in the paint from Minneapolis. Jason George, good defense. Charlie Lynn with a good board on the defense. We're on the move. Now on the wing, Kyle with the ball. And Halstead able to get back on defense. It's one thing they've been able to do. Good no call there by the ref. Casey all the way to the basket. It's good. Argenbright gets to the rack. Hits the one-hand floater, and Minneapolis got this thing back to 13 points. Good double team here, and quick timeout by the Halstead coach as he sees a nice run here by Minneapolis. Timeout. Full timeout. We'll be back after this minute timeout.
1:49 to go in the third. Lions trailing 40-27.
We're geared to play it in for Halstead out to Retzlaff. Now good steal by Kyle. Can get the handle on it. Now he kicks it back. Armendariz. Oh my. He was all over the top of Argenbright, and they're going to call Casey with the block. Armendariz will go to the free throw line to shoot two here. Argenbright's first foul. Armendariz free throw rattles in and out and back in again. 41-27, Dragons. Second throw is good. Starting to find the range from the free throw line.
They've only missed three this quarter.
Kyle, baseline shot, no good. Grayson George finds room and is fouled. Nice board underneath. George with some ups. Rakes that rebound out of there on the offensive glass. The stick back, he is fouled. And he'll go to the free throw line to shoot two here. Freshman with some good minutes here this afternoon. Free throw, good. Grayson's got a nice stroke from the free throw line there. Second throw. Rims out and back in. Armendariz now off to Vermillion as the Dragons break the timeline and the pressure put on them by Minneapolis. Betzlav. No one to throw to. Now Vermillion comes to get it for the Dragons. Guarded closely by Casey Argenbright. Breslav puts the ball on the floor. Now Regeer on the wing. Man-to-man defense by Minneapolis. Vermillion. Halstead in no hurry here. I think the coach would like to see them work the ball for one shot here, Dale.
I assume so, yeah.
Unless they get the layup. Regeer with the ball now on the wing to Armendariz. Skip pass to Vermillion. He's liable to uncork a three at any time. Slick little left-hand guard backdoor to Restlap. Nice pass. 5 seconds left. Two to shoot. Casey Argenbright shot off the front of the rim. No good at the buzzer. What a nice back door by Halstead there just at the end of the
just
third
what
period.
They were looking for. We provided it. 44-29 in favor of
the Lions. Casey Argenbright will play it in for Minneapolis. Charlie Lynn, now to Kyle on the wing. Baseline drive, Regeer. Is whistled with the foul. That's his first foul. Halstead's third team foul, and Logan Whittle will play it in. Charlie Lynn's outlet pass is stolen by Regeer. All the way to the basket, layup is good. I think most of the guys on their team are left-handed. Quickly down the court, Minneapolis out front. Grayson George rescues it as it's tipped away by Retzlaff. Now Logan Whittle with an open look. Three ball is good. Spot up shooter from the wing, and Logan Whittle hammers down a three ball. Retzlaff to Garnett. Now on the move. They have numbers. It's stolen by Casey Argenbright. Stolen back by Armendariz. Now they have numbers. And they pull it out.
46-32, Halstead. 6:43 to go in the game.
Regeer with the ball out on top. Now on the wing, Retzlav. Now back to Regeer, baseline. Doesn't pull the trigger. As Ratcliffe has the ball now on the wing for the Dragons, being closely guarded by Casey Argenbright. Now an overplay by Redcliff. They're just not too big of a to take a shot, are they? 46-32, Halstead. Redcliff back out front to Regeer. Now Armendariz. Oh. That's live now with the ball being hounded by Logan Wheatle in the corner, Ratcliffe. They're running some clock here, aren't they, Dale?
Yep, they don't mind it at all.
Good defense by Minneapolis. A double team leaves Ratcliffe open from the side. He buries the baseline shot.
They're leading. He's leading their team with 16 points.
Logan Wheatle down the lane. He goes. Jump stop. Called for the walk. Turnover, Minneapolis. I think Logan had the shot right there. He should have just went ahead and took the layup. Garnett and Vermillion back in. Murray on the move. Ball intercepted by Corey. Back inside to Garnett. And in.
When things go well for you, they go well. I mean, that's just slop.
Baseline, jump shot, no good.
Just plain slop.
Boy, they're on the floor, don't they? 2-on-1, and they have another layup. .444 left. And a quick timeout by Coach Shoup. Looks like it's a full timeout, so we'll be back after this one-minute timeout.
By 20, 52, one to go. Lions with the ball.
Halstead with a scoring barrage there in the third quarter. Corey, nice spin move off the glass, no good. And Murray, or Vermillion, comes out of there with the ball as Corey hounds in down the court now. Tight defense by Minneapolis. Still man-to-man by the Lions. Skip pass. Retzlaff back to Armendariz. Ratcliffe with the ball on the wing, looking inside. Armendariz is there. Spin move all the way to the basket. He walked. Stumbled for just a second, lost his balance, and called for the turnover. Ratcliffe on Corey out front. Crossover dribble in the paint. McCulloch with the ball in tight, almost too tight, and Halstead called for the foul.
Fourth foul.
It's on Garnett.
Not a shooting foul.
We play it in, Logan with the ball out on top. Inside to McCulloch. Tries the baseline, turnaround jump shot, no good. Tipped out there by Kyle, picked up by Keegan, and he's called for the walk on the floor after that loose ball. Picked up his feet traveling. Logan with the good defense on Murray. Now out front with Regier on the wing to Ratcliffe, looking inside to Retzlaff. And Ratcliffe is hammered by Corey Lomberger. That's his fourth.
Ninth team foul for the Lions. 1-1.
Ninth team foul, as Dale mentioned, and Radcliffe will get the 1-1 here. First throw, no good. Keegan with the rebound. Casey Argenbright on the move now for Minneapolis. Schmidt. Kyle runs into Keegan. Jump shot in the lane. Nice move by Kyle Lomberger. Regeer with the foul. His second. And Kyle will go to the free throw line to shoot two. 2:41 left. Fourth quarter. First throw on its way. Rims off. Bole. Grayson heads to the scorer's desk. Free throw rims in. Kyle's second throw is good. And Grayson will come in for Logan.
.241 to go. 52-33, Halstead.
And they
went. Grayson George did not meet the dress code.
Grayson to tuck it in. That's live. Skip pass all the way down. Regeer saves it. Now back out front. And they reset the offense. Halstead playing with some of the second five that played quite a bit. Now on the wing, looking inside, Retzlaff is there. Notice this team just does not pull the trigger just any time they want to take a shot. They work the ball quite well. Retzlaff in the paint. Shot is good. Nice left-hand floater by Retzlaff. Argenbright hands it off to McCulloch. In the lane he goes. And I do believe
Keegan
they're going to call a foul.
Keegan draws the foul. Foul number six. He was going to the line. So.
Retzlaff with the foul.
And foul.
Keegan will get two shots here. First throw on its way. It's good. Gant back in for the Dragons. 54-34. Keegan's second throw is rimming off. George
reaches around and draws a
ticky tack foul there.
Tenth team foul. Double bonus coming up for the Dragons.
Buck 42 left. Gordon in for Halstead's first free throw, rims off. No good. They have not shot free throws as well.
Well, third quarter they did pretty good.
With the exception of two guys, seemed to be shooting pretty decent. Front rim. Grayson has the rebound for the Lions. Argenbright on the wing. Schmidt looks at the three. Missing. Argenbright with a chance for the save and stepped on the line.
I guess that's what he did. I didn't see it. But,
when he went airborne, he happened to have the toe on the line.
Oh, did he? All right.
Halstead breaks the pressure.
1:15 to go. 54-34.
Nice block by George.
Was that George or Keegan?
Got in close enough. I think Grayson had the block. I could have been wrong. They'll play it in under their own bucket. Easy bucket.
56-34.
Had our defense on the hip, and the good pass was right there. Grayson with the ball out on top. Hands it off to Schmidt. Down the lane he goes. Jump shot off front of the rim, and Argenbright with the loose ball. Keegan with a kiss off the glass there. Nice shot by McCulloch. The left hand bank shot. 25 seconds left here in this contest.
56-36 Halstead. Our kids are working tails off during this man-to-man defense.
They are. Halstead had a pretty good offense. 5-second call as Argenbright has a good defense, and that's the way it's going to end. 56-36. Halstead with the 20-point win here. Minneapolis will play Friday
2:30.
At 2:30.
Wow. El Saline, I think. Might be wrong there.
I think you're right.
They outscore 12-7 in the final stanza.
Well, good effort by the Lions. A little bit outmanned. Halstead a little more athletic at spots. I think they had a pretty good scheme on their offense. They had a pretty good man offense. They got the back door on us a couple times and they did a good job picking, and they had good position inside. Second chance points in there hurt us, and I'm sure we were out-rebounded quite a bit. We'll be back with those stats here in just a minute.
We'll get all that figured out. Okay, we're back, folks, here for a wrap-up of the game. Again, the Lions lose the third straight, followed by 20 points, 56-36 to the Halstead Dragons. We'll move on to the seventh place game against the Believe El Saline at 2:30 on Friday. Stats, we were scored every quarter, 13-9 in the first. I'll take it back, even at the second quarter, 8 each. Third quarter was the big quarter for the Dragons. They outscored us 23-12. And the fourth quarter, they outscored us 12-7. The Lions shot 14 of 32 for the game. For a 44% shooting for the Deuces. And we were 1 of 7 on trays. We were 5 of 10 on free throws for 50%. We had 18 rebounds compared to their 29, so they maintained that edge throughout the game. We had 18 fouls to their 15. We had 15 turnovers to their 12. So free rebounds, as far as I'm concerned, were a big telling factor tonight. They were 48% on free throws compared to our 50%, but they were at the line 23 times. They hit 11 of them. So they're there a lot more than we were. They hit 25% of their trays. They were 3 of 12. And they're 18 of 37 on their deuces for 49%. Scoring and points for the Lions. Keegan McCulloch, 7 points, 6 rebounds, no steals. Corey Lomberger, 11 points, 1 rebound, 2 steals. Kyle Lomberger, 2 points, or 1 point, 2 rebounds, 1 steal. Jared Schmidt, 2 points, no rebounds, no steals. Logan Wheatle, 9 points, 1 rebound. Grayson George, 4 points, 3 rebounds, 2 steals. Casey Augenbright, 2 points, 3 rebounds, and 3 steals. Charlie Lynn, no points and 2 rebounds. That kind of wraps up the tail of the game here. Again, I think they just really killed us underneath. That was the big advantage. And because of that, they ended up getting some foul shots that we didn't get. We got some putbacks, and we couldn't catch up.
One thing jumps out at me, Dale, the can't do a lot about the height factor and the rebound. We can get a little bit better position inside. And the turnovers, you know, when you have a turnover like that, you lose a chance and you give your opponent a chance for scoring. And when you have more turnovers than your opponent, it compounds the problem. And as you stated, getting out-rebounded as bad as we did makes it a little tough inside on the undermanned, I should say, shorter Minneapolis Lions. But they do a pretty good job. They can do better if they'd work on blocking out a little bit without fouling.
Yes. Well, that wraps up the game. We will sign off on the internet here and be back. The clock says 14 minutes and 50 seconds for the girls' game, so we'll be back in about 10 minutes or less. We'll sign back on for the girls' game as they get ready to play Sacred Heart Knights here in the semifinals. We'll be back. Thanks for listening, folks.